Hey guys, I'm at the ancient KailasaNathar temple in Kanchipuram, and today we're going to look at a strange feature related to geometry and sacred number system hidden here. Let's take a look at this carving of Dancing Shiva. This is a brilliant carving done at least 1,300 years ago, and you can see much of this carving has lost its paint. I have retouched this using Photoshop, and now you can see it much better. Here, Shiva is shown with one foot placed firmly on the ground, and the other leg is bent with his knee resting on the ground and the foot facing the sky. Shiva has put one arm on this foot while the other arm is lifted above his head. Let's forget his other arms for now. But here is another carving on the other side of the temple, which is even more eroded. When I saw this, I was shocked because it shows the exact same Dancing Shiva. But here is the strangest part. This carving is flipped horizontally like a mirror image of the first carving. In Photoshop, I am flipping this original image now, and you can begin to see the accuracy of how they both match. In the first carving, it is his left foot on the ground, and in the second carving, it is the right foot on the ground. All the legs and arms are flipped like this, like looking at yourself in the mirror. Not the same, but laterally inverted. But Shiva has so many hands. One of them is holding a ring, another is holding a weapon. All these details have to be mirrored. First of all, this is not easy to carve. This is a sculpting marvel, which would need machine-like precision. Even to show it to you online, I'm using software like Photoshop. Imagine I had to do it by drawing with my hands. I would have to be a good artist. Today, to carve something like this, we would need software and hardware, meaning machines, high-tech machines and tools. Second question, and the most important question is, why? Why did they have to create this kind of laterally inverted mirror image of a carving? What could possibly be the purpose for going through such pains to create it? And the position of these two carvings are quite intriguing as well. They're not randomly placed. One is on the left side of the temple, and the other is on the right side, as though they're trying to create a symmetry, especially something called bilateral symmetry. What is bilateral symmetry? It occurs all the time in nature. It is the property of being divisible into equal halves, but mirrored halves on either side of a plane. If I take a human body and put a line in the exact center and sort of separate them, I will have two equal but mirrored halves. But let's go to the levels of cells, right? Like microscopic, and see how this was created, right? Biologists will tell us, well, there's one cell and then it multiplies into two. But this is not mere multiplication, right? It is mirrored for natural symmetry. And of course, this is very hard to explain. So this is my right hand. And if I multiply it and put another hand right next to it, does it look like natural symmetry? No, it is multiplied by two. It's even identical, but it's not symmetrical. It actually looks weird because it's not natural. In order to make it symmetrical, I have to laterally invert this hand. I have to make a mirror image, which is what my left hand is. My left hand is actually a natural mirror image of my right hand. What you're looking at on the screen is actually a laterally inverted image placed next to my right hand. This is not my left hand. But you cannot tell the difference unless you look at my quote-unquote alien bloodline showing on my ring finger. And this is what nature is doing to all of us. It is creating a mirror image along a symmetrical point. This is extraordinary. And scientists are still debating over why nature is doing this. But this carving shows that ancient builders of India were following the same laws that nature is using. They did not create two carvings which look identical. They created two carvings in mirrored fashion for natural symmetry. And ancient builders seem to have understood something much more fascinating. If you take a cell, that cell multiplies in mirrored fashion. So one cell multiplies into 2, 2 into 4, 4 into 8, 8 into 16, and so on. If we study the geometry and symmetry of the KailasaNathar temple, it has been designed using the same system. Of course, this is one temple, but it has two secret passages known as the Gate of Death and the Gate of Birth on either side of the center point. It has four towers on the outer walls in the four-sided rectangle. Has 8 pyramids around the main tower, specifically designed to show 8 avatars of Shiva. But it does not stop there. 8 times 2 is 16. Inside the main chamber is a 16-faceted lingam with perfect angles between each sides. Another classic example of primitive technology. 16 multiplied by 2, you get 32. There are 32 bulls or nandis placed all around the temple. Some are on the ground. Some are on the top of the wall, and some are just completely gone. 32 times 2 is the number 64, and there are 64 avatars of Shiva carved on these walls. And it's very interesting to see something here. Even though we do have every avatar of Shiva carved at least twice in this temple, this carving, the one that shows the cosmic dance of Shiva, is the only carving that is laterally inverted. All the other carvings are not mirror images. Why is this? How is this cosmic dance related to nature and laws of nature? Was the cosmic dance of Shiva laterally inverted to make us understand about bilateral symmetry? And also, how did ancient builders come up with such remarkable symmetry and geometry? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. And I will talk to you soon. Bye.